Hi, Dad. Happy birthday. The reason I'm doing this is you're so hard to get a present for, so I thought I would take you along on my week before I come home to see you for your birthday. So it's now Saturday, November 14th. I'm at work because I'm putting together a show to run Wednesday morning because we're going to Vegas. You're coming with us. So what I thought I'd do is just take you through my apartment, which you haven't seen, show you all my furniture and all the stuff that I've gotten since you were here when you visited, and show you my life here, and take you to Vegas and, you know, let you see what's going on here. So I love you, and I wish I could do more for you, but I thought you'd enjoy this. So happy birthday, and we'll go through the week together.
A big kiss.
Go slow. And slow.
Hi again, Dad. This is Bill. You remember Bill, my boss. This is the big boss.
No, and see how short I am? She's not telling the truth.
And his wife, Joey, is shooting this. They're here on Saturday, too. I don't know why. I thought I'm the only crazy one to come in here.
No,
on
she puts in the worst hours of anybody here because she's up early in the morning. And then she's here late in the afternoon, so she's got worse hours than anyone.
See, Dad, I told you, I'm not just complaining. But, so I'm here doing this, but we have this thing going on here today. It's a food bank radiothon that they do every year. This is the seventh year, so I guess Bill came in to give some moral support and thank everyone for volunteering on the phone bank.
Yep, it's like the second biggest thing we do with the blood bank, and then this thing, besides all the promotions that you do.
Yeah. And,
you're not even at the promotion today at the Coliseum that Mark and Brian are in the USC band.
I had to work in here so we could go to Vegas this week. Mark and Brian are in the USC marching band today. Maybe you'll see it on TV, maybe not.
I think it is televised today.
So that's what we're doing here today. And you'll probably see Bill again because when I get back from Vegas on Wednesday, I'm going to just run around
Shoot
the
again?
Building.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
I got that double exposure. I'm in twice.
All right, well, that's it for now. I have to get back to work.
Okay, Dad. I'm finished. You see these two tapes? It's hard to shoot and talk at the same time. It's not really power cuts. It's, I've got two reels that I just edited with all that editing equipment. This is the first time I'm shooting this camera, so I've got to figure out how it works. So, I've been working in here. It's now, what time is it? 3:30. When we shot before, it was about 1 when Bill and Joey were here. So what we're going to do now is walk into the studio. It's hard to do this because I'm kind of blinded. There's the long hallway of KLOS. And that was the production room we were just in. We're going to walk into the studio where Mark Avery is on the air. And like I told you, they're working on this food bank thing. And here's the door. Hi!
Hi,
Dad.
Hi, Nicole's dad. Happy birthday. You have a very special daughter who loves you very much.
Oh, that's Mark, cute. And that's Rita.
I'm Mr. Sandler. How you doing? We're saying happy birthday to you. Hope that you're doing well and hanging in there. We're
thanks, guys.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday and many more.
That's right. Many more.
Yeah.
I'm trying to figure out how to turn this camera off now.
Usually the off button does that.
Okay, we're back in the hallway again, and now we're going to walk down to my office, okay, because I finished editing the tape, but now I've got to write up the rundown sheet, type all that up, because Rita, who's also our music director, will come in and run it Wednesday morning. I won't be back here from Vegas until about probably 10 o'clock Wednesday, so... you know what? I'm going to peek my head in the conference room where all the people are answering the phones for this radiothon we have going on. And so you can see what's going on in here. Pretty amazing, huh? A lot of busy people in here. They're all answering phones. There goes the phone now. Say hi.
Hello.
Say happy birthday to my dad.
Happy birthday, Nicole's dad.
All right, so there's everyone
Al's
in here.
Weather out there in Florida.
Okay, I guess.
Happy birthday, Mr. Sandler.
Thanks, guys. All right, we're going to continue down the hallway. See, all these people are in here on a Saturday answering phones trying to raise money for all the hungry people in L.A. And there are a lot of them. Now, don't be shocked when you see my office. It may remind you of my bedroom when I was a kid growing up, okay? All right. Here we go. But I'll try to give you a good view of everything going on here. That's Chuck Connors, who just died. He was a good friend of the show. That's our friend Mark Bonilla. That's a thing that they sent us from Northern Exposure. You ever watch that TV show? It's a great show. You should watch it. It's on Monday nights at 10. Just all kinds of stuff in here. There's my desk. Oh no, and all the junk. There's our calendar with things that's going on my shelves. That's our traffic reporter. Pretty gross, huh? And there's just stuff as I give you a good view of the office. Pretty crazy, huh? That's from the now defunct Mark and Brian television show. Just all kinds of stuff in here. All yeah, it's a mess. All right, and that's our door and notes and faxes and stuff stuck on it. All right, back to my desk. All right, this is where I sit. And the guys usually sit across from me. And that's my typewriter. And I'm going to do some work now, so I'll talk to you in a little while. Okay, Dad, we're back in the studio again. That's the cue sheet. I'm finally finished putting together this show, and it is, it's 4:20. So that's how I've spent my Saturday. Anyway, I'm going to pack all this stuff up, clean up my mess here. See all my mess here? And head home. What I may do, it's beautiful outside, so I may take you for a little walk, show you my neighborhood. I'm not going to show you my apartment yet, only because, because it's a mess, and the maid is going to come on Monday. So I'll show you the inside of my apartment when we get back from Las Vegas. But maybe I'll show you the neighborhood today, all right? So we'll be back in a minute. Okay, Dad. We're near my house, and I just pulled over really fast because the sun is going down, and I figured I'd show you a beach sunset, and we just about missed it. Oh, no. See, there's the sun going down. Maybe I can get a better one on Wednesday. Oh, it was so beautiful as I was driving here. You know what? I'm going to go back this way so you can just see the end of it. Oh, that's too bad. Where is it? There it is. You can zoom in as if... Oh, maybe it's the other way. There it goes. Pretty, huh? Can you see all the people along the shore? Just watching the sunset? It is really nice living here. Now, unfortunately, this is the drainage pit here. It's not a real nice area. I mean, it's a nice area, but this is the beach. This is where I live. That's Pacific Coast Highway. And you really can't see my apartment from here, but maybe if I walk this way, you can. I'm having to watch for bikes because I'm going along the bike path. Okay. Now you see? I'm going to try to zoom into it. That building there. Maybe it'll... There. It's focusing. That's where I live. Okay. And you'll see more of it. And I'm not going to walk down there now, but I'll take you down there, hopefully. Right, you can see the pretty sunset. Actually, it's been really clear here lately because of what they call the Santa Ana winds. They blow everything out over the water. And the more smog that's over the water, the nicer the sunsets. But here's my view. Pretty cool, huh? All right, well, I've got a few errands I have to run. Like I said, I just pulled off by the house so you could see the sunset. Good morning. It's Sunday morning. I was running really late yesterday, so I didn't turn this on before I went out. But I went out to see Tim Allen last night, do a stand-up thing. He was really good. This is the view from my balcony. See, this is, that's a really good restaurant, by the way. And this is what's right across the street. And Santa Monica Canyon goes way back there. Maybe I'll take a walk down there later and show you. But that's my ocean view. Pretty cool, huh? Let's see. It's, I don't know, it's about 10:30 now. And I'm getting ready to get dressed and go out and hopefully buy some clothes to take to Vegas with me. This is the dead tree on my balcony. These are some live plants before I kill them. This is stuff I got to get rid of, but this is my balcony. And I don't think I'm going to give you a view of the apartment yet, just because it's still a mess. But that's a really nice building over there that they just renovated, where apartments go for $3 million apiece. Thought you'd like to see that over there in the distance. All right, well, I'm going to hit the shower and go out shopping, and I'll talk to you later.
Hi, Dad. It's Monday morning, and we're in the studio. We're running commercials now. That's Mark.
Greetings, Mr. Sandler.
And what time is it? It's like 20 to 9.
Yeah.
So we're going to come out on the air in a few minutes. There's Brian. Say hi, Brian.
Hi, buddy. Listen, I got a joke for you, but we got to wait a minute. We're going to tell you a joke. We know how you like them sick ones.
Okay, so I'm going to have Sluggo, like, shoot in here while we're on the air, so you could see what happens during a break.
What are you going to have him shoot?
Shoot us.
With a camera?
Uh-huh. Okay. So I'm going to give the camera to Sluggo when we come out on the air, and he's going to just shoot video so you can see what we do in here. Okay?
We're thinking about you. I want you to know.
Right. Hold on, Dad. When we come out, we'll be on the air.
This is a good parade thing.
Oh, good. Okay.
Some of the entries for the parade on
Friday.
Friday. And it is shaping up. We do have room for creative, fun, stupid, ridiculous ideas. So if you have those, feel free to call the switchboard day or night, 24 hours a day. They have, switchboard closes off at midnight?
Right, okay. From 6 a.m. to midnight.
Okay, and they have the forms that can fill out your idea. We'll go through them quickly and get back with you quickly to let you know where you stand on that. Because we are 1 week away from Wednesday, is the parade. And you already need to be thinking in terms of, if you're not going to be in the parade, think in terms of coming down to be with us.
Got a lot of stuff, so get your ideas in soon, because it is filling up very fast. And fun stuff this year, as well as the USC band, the marching coach, is going to be in it too.
A lot more room to put you in.
And we also want to thank you, the listeners, and all the volunteers who worked all through the weekend for the 7th Annual Food Bank Radio Fund. Get this, Judge. $197,716 raised. You multiply that by 20, because $1 buys $20 worth of food through the food bank. It's kind of a complicated reason why, but just know it honestly does. So we have now made enough money to purchase 3 million of YouTube to support the things that KLOS does each and every year on an annual basis.
It's a very community-minded radio station. One of the best in the country. That's why our creative service and community switchboard and all that win awards every year.
Yeah.
Big award.
Yeah.
And now that the food bank radiothon is over, we do have numbers at the switchboard that if you're in need of food, if you're hungry, if you want to know where to go to get some help, they've got all those numbers in there, and just call the switchboard.
If you're in one of those in need, the reason why these listeners and the volunteers did it for you, then you give us a call at the switchboard and they'll let you know where to go.
In 17 minutes, Glenn Fry will be in this room, and we have listener Mark on 13 who does, and this is rarely before heard, a Glenn Fry impression.
How do you do Glenn Fry?
Not real sure. Hey, Mark.
Hey, yes.
How are you, buddy? Okay, so now, Mark, give us your Glenn Fry impression.
Ready.
Oh, brother.
Yeah, it really wasn't.
That was like Satchmo.
That was.
Well, you know, if you had Satchmo tickets, I'd really go for them too, but I'm a big Glenn Fry fan, big Eagles fan, big Joe Walsh fan. Nobody deserves them more.
Mike. Yeah. Take the tickets.
We heard the impression.
Take the tickets.
Don't get us wrong, it was incredible.
Thanks for calling, Mike.
Oh, my.
Although, with that same voice, it might be good to hear him sing Hello, Dolly.
Yeah, try that. All right, we got to really go because this is a quick break, right? We have to go now?
Yeah.
Was there something else?
Well, no. Lynette had advice on the female masturbation thing we had earlier. She had advice
is
on
she a
that.
Professional?
I don't know. Let's ask her real quickly. Lynette on 11. Lynette!
Hello.
How are you?
Fine. How are you guys?
Are you a professional?
Who do you? Don't mean to rush you here, but we got to kind of.
That's okay.
There you go.
My dad was watching the Pornos movie one time, and my 4-year-old sister walked in. And so he panicked and said, okay, when you're in college, we deal with it. All I did was answer her question. She's like, and they were giving oral sex at the time, and she's like, well, what were they doing? And so I just said, it's an adult thing. You don't panic. Act natural. And if you don't panic, you won't think anything of it. and it's never come up again.
But now, your sister at this time was 4.
Uh-huh.
Okay, now see, this girl is 10.
Yeah, but still, I think even though she's 10, I mean, you obviously talk to her differently with a 10 than you would a 4-year-old, but you just, you know, answer her questions. Don't make it seem like it's a big deal, because if you act like it's a big deal, then she's going to make a big deal about it.
Yeah.
And, you know, I don't know, that's how we did it with her, and I know, excuse me, I've had other friends that, you know, situations like that have come up, and they've answered the questions honestly, and not drug it out, not made a big deal about it.
Uh-huh.
You deal with it when they ask you about it, and then you kind of drop the subject. If it comes up again, then you talk about it, but you don't worry about it all the time, because kids...
It's a little advice for you.
I agree with her on the panicking thing, but I still don't know how I handled it.
Well, the only thing I just dislike is growing up, I never really got that big sexual conversation. I never had anything explained to me. And I wanted that. I want that, and I will provide that for my children.
But, well, Dad, I mean, came up and said, do you have any questions? And I forget how old I was, maybe around 12 or 13. And I knew everything by then, or most of the stuff. I still thought screwing and... effing were two different things.
Two separate things.
I thought, I want to try one. I thought screwing had to do with actually a spinning thing or something.
I did too.
You did?
Yes.
Didn't you?
I never really thought about that.
Yeah, I thought it was like a thing you had to...
Well, see, now, we were young boys. We thought about everything we heard. We thought about it in detail and what exactly does happen there.
And then one guy said, I heard a high schooler talk in a locker room once. He goes, yeah, I had a baller like that. And I went... Oh, what happens there?
Haven't heard that one.
Three different ways now. But when I went to my dad came to me and said, do you have any questions? So he was ready for the talk. I said, well, I kind of know everything, but one thing. What is pink box time, which is what my dad referred to and the kids as when mom was having her menstrual cycle. Because she always got grouchy and she went to the store and came back with a big pink box. And I didn't know what to do with them. I was using them for bunkers for my G.I. Joes. And I didn't know exactly. They were always in the bathroom cabinet there.
So let me guess. He said, ask mom.
No, he told me. I remember we were upstairs, and he said he told me. But, you know, he told me. That was really nice of him.
When I finally did go to my father with a question or two, I asked him if it was true that the guy puts his thing in the woman, and he said, yes, it is. And I said, well, does it feel good? Because at this point I was, like, not believing it, because I had been told at school. He said, well, yes. So then I went up into the kitchen where Mother was, and I said, Daddy just told me, and I told her, and I said, does it feel good to you? Yep, I see your father out in front yard. Why don't you go talk to him a little bit more, son? Thanks
a lot. Oh, that was hard for Mary to do, too.
Oh, boy. All right, well, you know, the thing of it is with kids, they're forced to grow up a lot sooner now than we did. And things that we found out at 12 or 13 or 14, they're finding out 8, 9, and 10 because of the way things are. As a dad, I just don't want him or Amy to go through that weird period where they don't know what's happening to their body. I want them to be fully abreast of all that.
You might, so to speak, you might want to question, too. You know, they learn in school a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And by the time you have that conversation with him, I bet you he knows just about everything.
Here's a scenario I want to ask about. This weekend. Let's say, for example, you're at work someplace and you go back into the storage room to get something and you're reaching up on a shelf to get it. While you're in there, you hear the door open and shut. Two co-workers come in and they begin to frantically do it right there in the room. They don't know you're there. Would you clamber around and let them know that you're there and then awkwardly leave? Would you remain silent and watch each and every event that took place?
What do you think? Of course. There's no question. First of all, I'd make sure if there was a chance that they could catch me. If I was very hidden, of course I would watch. If there was a chance that they'd look around, like in Dances with Wolves, and they see Kevin Costner just staring right at him, I would probably, like, because I wouldn't want to be caught trying to sneak watching this. Yeah, so no, I would absolutely watch.
Nicole?
You'd have to ask me that now. We're shooting this video for my father. Hi, Dad. This is great stuff.
Oh,
here's your daughter's answer.
Sluggo's in here taping the video for her dad.
Here's your daughter's answer.
I think I'd let them know I was there and get out of the room fast.
Big lie!
Oh, my God.
Big lie!
Oh, my God. Your nose is growing. You're going to be eaten by a whale.
Alan, you've raised a lying woman.
Nicole.
We're shooting a video for my father.
Nicole.
Yeah.
Now, your dad, you're old. He knows that you're sexually promiscuous.
Would you seriously let him know you're there and that get out? Or
I guess it depends who the people were.
Chuck?
Oh, I agree with Brian's answer completely. If I was pretty well hidden, there was no chance I was going to get caught, I'd stay and watch the whole thing.
Arlo? I might do just more than watch, too.
Okay, that was my next question.
If there was no chance I'd get caught.
If there's no chance you get caught and you're watching the scenario, would you
jump in?
No. Just,
yeah.
You know. Oh, yes, I can't talk about it. I don't know.
Just, you know.
Yeah. Okay. I'd make sure I was there spiritually.
Arlo?
Yeah, I wouldn't want to ruin the moment for them.
Yeah?
I
wouldn't want to ruin the moment for you either.
Yeah, I like the moment.
Boy, it's too bad we weren't taking this video Friday when we were doing your worst sexual experiences. Right, Nicole? What? Excuse me? What?
Why don't turn the Sluggo, camera on?
Are you getting this? Uh-huh. All right.
It's time to go. We have Todd coming up.
All right. We do. Okay, let's take a break. We'll talk about yesterday's football, and then we have Glenn Frey at 9 o'clock, so stand by. It is the Mark and Brian program, 95.5 KLOS.
Hey, pretty chipper this morning.
I just joined 7-Eleven's new coffee refill.
Cool question.
Okay, we're in the studio. I'm whispering because they're on the air. We have an interview with Glenn Frey. He's a big, big rock star. So I'll just show you a little bit. See, Brian comes around here. And runs the board when we have an interview because we have a tiny studio. This guy Glenn Frey was with the Eagles. So now you see what happens. It's it's about 10 minutes to 10, so we're almost done, and then we're going to leave for Vegas at noon. So, now you see this, and we'll talk to you later.
Hey, Dad, this is Bob Coburn. It's now a little after 10, we're off the air, and Bob Coburn follows us at 10.
Or 10:15, or 10:30, or 10:45.
Whenever we decide to get off the air.
Hi, Ellen. Happy birthday. Hope you're doing okay back there in Florida. I'm glad you escaped the hurricane, and I haven't met you yet, but I look forward to doing that someday. And I know what kind of quality your daughter is, so I'm sure you're the same kind of guy. So happy birthday to you, Ellen.
Okay. Hi, Dad. We're on the plane going to Vegas. There's Mark. Say hi, Mark.
I'm reading your daughter's Cosmopolitan magazine. That's how bad the flight is. Just wanted you to know.
Okay.
Hope you're feeling better. Good to see you. Take care.
Now we're going to pan around. There's Brian. He's reading Motor Trend. And that's Gary. Say hi, Gary.
Welcome to the world of CDQ 2000. It's your digital audio coder.
Say happy birthday.
Birthday. How old are you anyway? You don't look it.
All right, Gary's our engineer.
Yeah.
He's going to get us on the air tomorrow morning from Vegas.
Well, if I wake up in time.
So I see him from Vegas. Hey, Brian. Say hi.
Hey, Ellen. What's going on? How are you doing? Let's get back to your daughter's sexual practices.
Hi, Dad. Hi, Dad. It's, what day is today? Tuesday morning.
Tuesday, early.
This is our makeshift broadcast center in Las Vegas. I would have talked to you yesterday, except I couldn't get my bags, because that's Gary. Say hi, Gary.
Hi. Very cool.
He's
I lost
our,
the bags.
He's our engineer, and he had my bags all day, including the camera, so that's why I didn't shoot anything yesterday. But we're in the lovely Sahara Hotel.
Hey, Alan. I lost $50 last night betting on Miami in Buffalo 1. I should have called you for advice on that. What was the line? Do you know what the line was?
No.
I wanted Miami to win and they lost.
Oh well, so this is our exciting broadcast. It's about 6:30 in the morning and we're in the restaurant, some like dumpy restaurant in the Sahara, which is really dumpy too. My room is actually pretty gross. And Mark and Brian are staying at the Mirage because they're stars. And that was feedback. So, anyway, if it gets exciting in here, we're supposed to have all these big rock stars coming by. So if they do, I'll turn the camera back on. If I don't, it's because this was a boring show. All right? Talk to you later. Say bye, Gary. Say bye, Gary.
Bye.
Dad, Okay, it's now a little after 9 o'clock. It's about 9:15. And this room is filled with major rock stars. There's, of course, Mark and Brian. That's Graham Nash. That's Jeff Scott Baxter. That's Johnny Anderson talking now from Yes. Mindy will know who all these people are. That's Alan Parsons. You can't see him, it's from the back. That's Ken, that's Mark Volman from Flo and Eddie, that's Scott Page. At the back table, there are a bunch more rock stars. This is like big time people here. So I'm whispering because we're all on the air right now. I'm gonna walk around the other side so you can see these people, okay? Excuse my camera work. That's Gary again. Here are people watching. That's Steve Ferris from Mr. Mister and some big rock people. And that's John Anderson talking. Alan Parsons over there. I know you don't know who these people are, but they are major rock stars. Okay. And that's Graham Nash.
The largest circle jerk. All right. Right now, as we said earlier, we have been through rehearsal, and we're the MC. We still don't know what we're doing.
They're talking about the event that's going on tonight.
I don't want to ask you questions, so if there's anything anybody wants to throw in, throw it in.
Well, what will happen is that you'll just get on the tail of this monster, and it will take you.
Right? No, well, I think that's what Scott wanted. We'll just hang on tight.
Hang on tight.
We're singing.
We know that.
And I'm not, so don't worry.
Scott, with the musicians in here, can you tell us exactly kind of the things they're going to hear tonight, just the songs and who's going to be singing them?
I'm going to pull out this mic so you can hear the room stuff going on.
And along with the sound things. And the fish.
No.
All right, then.
Basically, I'm so tired I can hardly speak. This has been the most wild, wild adventure I've ever been on, I gotta tell you.
It's never happened to you yet, Scotty.
Yeah. So it's happening now. But, I mean, the whole idea of this thing was to kind of do, because of technology, is usually something that's considered, and everybody thinks of it being real, real regimented, stiff, real accurate, and, you know, perfectly synchronized. Mm-hmm. Well, the idea of this whole thing was to do it, kind of take it on a different level, was to do something that was very loose with
technology. You got the right boys for that. Christmas shows.
And, but, yeah, exactly. And it was actually modeled after, the concept was modeled after your Christmas show.
Right.
And so the idea was is just to bring all these people together, all this stuff, let people push buttons, make things go, and have visual and audio kind of big jam jazz kind of a thing, and just let it go and see what happens. So I call it kind of controlled spontaneity. We set up this thing, and then you just stand back and let it go. I'm not even sure yet.
Looking at the floor last night, was sitting up in some of the seats and looking down on it, for some reason, it takes on the visual look of like a UFO. And it all, when all the stuff is working, lights and the sound of this, and there's this big, powerful, moving machine. What will happen if there is a total shutdown, if this entire thing goes, whoa?
We go acoustic.
We go acoustic. You know, and you know, I got to tell you, that's.
What will happen if the sound man gets the blame?
I got a feeling it's going to be that guy in Airport, you know, with the little unplugging thing. Oh, just kidding.
Sorry. Sorry, Dave.
But see, it's
a bad day to quit sniffing oil.
You know, the funny thing, but an interesting thing about that is you know, that can actually sometimes work to your benefit. Mm-hmm. You know, when those things happen. That's why I've got you guys and Charlie and stuff just to, like, say, hey, you can yell. You keep having it until we get it back up again and we're going.
Oh, good. All right. Well, we tried our best to tell you what this is, and you still probably don't know because, again, we don't. It is a big conglomeration of some of the best rock and roll musicians in the business, some of the best computer technology that is available and some that isn't, and it's all going to be meshed into one show tonight at the Thomas Mack Arena. It isn't really open to the public, from what we're understanding. It's just for these Comdex people.
Right. But if you're the public and you want to go, just go to Comdex, buy a ticket, then go buy a ticket, and then come to our show.
So it is kind of open to the public. So if you wanted to come, you could.
So to you, it's about $178.
Yeah. Listen, all of you, thank you very much for coming.
Hi, Dad. It's a quarter to one now. Obviously, we're finished with the show, and now we're in the arena. And a lot of the same people that you saw on the show this morning are in here. There's Brian studying his thing. studying his stuff, and I'm going to walk over to the stage and let you see. There's somebody else shooting video here, so I'm not the only one walking around with the camera, because this is a really, really major event. And I'm going to show you. I'm going to walk right into where all the musicians are playing, okay, because this is the rehearsal. This is all happening tonight. There's Scott Page, who's putting the whole thing together. He's a good friend of ours. He does all our Christmas shows and birthday shows. There's a guy from the Turtles. There's a big bass player. That's the guy from Mr. Mister. On the drums over there is Jim Keltner, who's from the Traveling Wilburys. On the piano is Edgar Winner. I don't know who that guitar player is. I'm sure he's somebody. So this is it. And people are looking at me like I'm crazy because I'm talking into the microphone. So they have all this weird computer stuff going on. See the screens over there? This is merging computers with the music industry. I'm going to walk right through the stage here. There's Scott Page. Hey, Scotty.
Say happy birthday to my dad.
Hey, happy birthday, Pop. Hope you're having a good day. We're having a wild day, I've got to tell you. Yo.
Thanks. Scott Page is a cool guy. And there's the horn section over there. And I'm going to get off the stage. Edgar Winner. Mindy, you know who he is. Marcy knows who he is. All right. I'm going to head out of here. And maybe I'll shoot a little more as we get into the actual show. There's some of the weird video stuff that's going to be going on. All right, I'm going to turn this off for now. I'll be back later. Hi, it's me again. We're still in rehearsal. This is John Anderson from Yes, rehearsing one of his songs for tonight. I'm going to try to move around the other side. It's going close. Hey, good camera work, huh? Todd Rundgren is about to walk into the picture. Major big time rock star. It's pretty wild, huh? Alright. That's Todd Rundgren. Okay, they're about to rehearse a number with everybody in the band. Just like a lot of big name people.
Everybody ready?
Bass player back there from The Who. Another bass player from Phil Collins. That guy from Mr. Mister. This guy here from the Doobie Brothers. There's Edgar Winter. Up on stage, John Anderson, Graham Nash, The Turtles. Dan, I know you're just loving this, a rock concert rehearsal.
Drummer, okay, Jim, why don't you
pad
this up? You don't give me some love, bro? Let's see what... Let's see what you're doing. Let's see what you're doing. I'll count it off. Just be
Before we start, documentary crew, please report to Brett Leonard over here by the monitor desk right now. Documentary crew, right now, report to Brett. Okay, here we go. Give me some. One, two, and. Twice the top, every time after that one time. Okay, let's take it from the right after the solo, one time, and then right into the solo. I mean, right after the vocal, one time on the figure out.
And here's Mark, hard at work while this is all going on.
Thank you.
you see me? Am I in focus? Hi, Dad. You know, I've been shooting a lot of video here, but I figured I'd talk to you so you could see that I'm actually here, that it's not someone else. Like, shooting the video, and then I put in the voiceover afterwards. So what are you doing? Showing my new boots? New boots? Thank you very much. Mark, the video's for my dad. Mark is shooting it, and he's got a really filthy mind. So I'll shoot a little bit more. I know you're not crazy about the music stuff, but just so you know, Marcy and Mindy will be really excited by all the people that are on this video, because there's like major stars here, and they asked Mark and Brian to MC this thing. I have no idea why, because they don't know anything about music. And that's Mark laughing because he knows it's true. So I'll shoot more of the rehearsal just because it's exciting, and you know, you can always fast forward through those parts, okay? I'll be back in a bit. Turn it off.
Do you like Andrew Winter?
He's
Dad. It's, what day is today? What? It's Wednesday. It's Wednesday at 12:20. I'm back at work. I flew in this morning. Took an 8 o'clock flight out. Yesterday, after, you know, I didn't shoot too much of that rehearsal because I didn't think you'd care to see all these rock and rollers and playing music and everything. So I didn't take the camera to the event last night. It was really great. It was exciting and different and fun. And I got to bed about 2 o'clock in the morning, and I woke up at 6 this morning and flew back here. Got back to work about 10 o'clock, and working just a lot of stuff. We have, well, I'm flying home tomorrow. Here's my calendar. After the show, I fly home tomorrow, and then I come back Sunday, and then on Wednesday is our parade, and then the following week, we're up here, is Mark's birthday show, and then 2 weeks after that is the Christmas show. So I've got a lot of work to do, and I'm tired. I slept, like, you know, like 4 hours last night, and not much the night before, but it was fun, and this is what, you know, my life is like here.
Just scan the room or what?
That's Rhonda, who's shooting the video.
Hi, Alan. Happy birthday.
Give me the camera.
Hold on. Wait, it's on.
It's okay. It's on. This is my great camera work, yeah. Okay.
Hi, happy birthday. I've heard a lot of wonderful things about you. Happy birthday. Nicole's wonderful. I love her. She's like a sister. I'm going to find her a nice Jewish guy to marry, okay? I'm the Jewish influence.
Rhonda's one of the salespeople here. She's one of my best buds in the building. And but, you know, she goes off with a jet set life, and she never hangs out with me.
Give me a break. We still have to celebrate your birthday.
Yeah, I know.
All right.
She was, where were you on my birthday? In Mexico or something?
Yeah, in the Caribbean.
Oh, excuse
me. In the Caribbean.
Me. With some rich boyfriend.
Please. But he's a nice Jewish boy, and he's a liar.
Very happy. But you're not marrying him.
Who knows? Anyways, happy birthday. Take this off of me. Goodbye.
Dad, this is Janine. She's another salesperson, another one of my favorite people here. She's pregnant with, see, there's her belly, with their second baby.
Yes.
And she's married to Leonard here, who's another salesperson.
Hi, Alan. Alan, first of all, congratulations on raising one of the most wonderful people that was ever born. You did a super job with your Nicole. And I hope you have a wonderful birthday, and we all think about you often, and we love you, and stay out of those hurricanes.
Lori, come back. Lori, thanks, Janine. Say happy birthday to my dad.
Happy birthday. Happy B-Day.
Have a wonderful birthday.
and that's Lori, and she works in the promotions department, and we're hockey buddies, and we hang out together.
Buddies. And Bruce.
And Bruce Springsteen,
I'm buddies. The one in the flower dress right next to her on TV, acting like the big geek. And in the picture.
Yeah.
You gotta show him that.
I awesome. Will when I shoot my apartment.
Nicole and I are retiring after we got that picture. The Thanksgiving with Bruce picture.
Yeah.
Have a happy birthday.
Happy B-Day. Bye.
This is CW Dad. He hates being on video.
Hi, Dad. Hope you're feeling okay. Hope you have a great birthday. Hope Nicole's feeding you and making you big meals while she's down there and entertaining you and playing lots of cards and going
That's
to Disney World?
It. No.
Oh, okay.
We'll just hang out.
Have fun.
Thanks.
Enjoy.
That's CW.
Hope you got my present. She should give it to you. Ask, beg her until she gives it to you.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
All right, this is the promotions office. This is where CW works. I'll walk in his office while he's not there. You'll see it's a lot cleaner than mine. See, this is CW's office. In this box, let's open it up. These are our Christmas cards. You're going to love this, Dad. Oh, that's not the Christmas cards. Where are the Christmas cards? Maybe it's this box. Aha. All right. See? Hold on. Let's focus on that. Mark and Brian Christmas cards. And I'm not going to tell you what it is until you see it. You'll open them up and you'll see for yourself. I don't think you can focus this close. Alright, so, see, his office is a lot cleaner than mine. He's not quite as busy. He doesn't have to share his office with two maniacs like I do. Alright, we'll walk into the outer office of the promotion department. That's Ruben.
Show him my card.
Ruben, right. Say hi.
Hello, dear.
Say happy birthday to my dad.
Happy birthday. Got you looking good.
Yeah. We're taking this video home to Florida tomorrow.
Cool. Check my wall.
Do I want to show Ruben's wall? There are all his women that he meets.
Oh, there's a new addition.
Something came in while I was out.
Well. I think the guys around here have like one thing on their mind.
Yeah.
Did they give you phone numbers too?
No.
No, sorry.
I have to go elsewhere.
And you met Lori before, but here she is again, and
in
here's
her
desk.
Little lion's den.
See, she's got Mel Gibson.
Aerosmith.
She has Aerosmith.
Hockey, Bruce.
Guns N' Roses, hockey. Who's that? Bruce. Aerosmith again.
Aerosmith.
Bruce. And I'll show you the picture she was talking about before.
Oh, I don't have it. Oh, here it is. I have it here.
And you'll see it again when we get... Wait, I gotta focus. See, that's us with Bruce Springsteen after the MTV Unplugged. You'll see it hanging in my apartment if the maid came while I was away. Hopefully she did. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to see my apartment. Sorry, Dad.
Having Thanksgiving with Bruce.
Thanksgiving?
It doesn't it look like we're just sitting there having
Thanksgiving dinner? Yes, it does.
Nicole, go away.
See, everyone else's offices are a lot cleaner than mine.
That's because I'm anal retentive at work.
And because I share an apartment with two... an office with two slobs.
Yes.
See, I'm really tired, Dad. I got no sleep last night. What time
Nicole,
is it now?
Turn this thing off.
Almost
2
o'clock.
Bye, Nicole. Bye, Dad. Happy birthday.
What's he doing?
Dad, this is Tina. She's my assistant. So if you ever call here and you want to find me and you don't get me and you get another girl, you'll get Tina.
It's me.
And Tina is right now dubbing a bit for you on tape. See, onto cassette. One of the ones that I'm going to play for you. It's off of that tape and onto that tape. So, see, I'm making her work on a personal project.
On company time.
On company time.
So,
it's the Jeopardy bit. And this is Steve Smith. Remember, just a couple of minutes ago, we were in the promotion department, and we were going around to all the offices. Well, he's the boss of that department, and he wasn't at his desk.
I was busy working, Nicole.
Wait, hold on. What happened to that tape?
What? That was done.
It was?
Yeah.
Hello, Steven.
They were just
Hello,
doing
Bill.
The Jeopardy
music. We're shooting a video
music.
For Nicole's
Oh, that was the end
dad?
Yeah,
it was
the end.
Oh, that's our boss, Bill Severs.
He was here Saturday with me, and he already spoke on
What's your dad's name?
Alan.
Alan, you don't know me, but you probably don't recognize me. I've lost 11 pounds.
He's been doing Nutrisystem.
Yeah, see that?
Let's get the wide shot.
See those?
Wow.
That's what's happening. I'm going to lose another 20 pounds and just in time for the holidays.
Wow.
But anyway.
That's admirable.
I hope you're doing okay. We're working on a lot of projects here and trying to talk Nicole into getting some rest. She's got a busy schedule ahead.
After the Christmas show, right?
Yeah. After December 18th, you can rest up.
Thanks.
All right.
So it's his birthday.
Oh, it is. Well, happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Feliz cumpleaños.
That's cool.
And that's Allison in there. She works for the AM side. We don't
I
really
work
talk
the
about
FM
it.
Side too.
Okay, yeah, she works on the switchboard for us.
As the boss just walks by.
Have a good birthday. Have a good birthday from all of us here at KLOS, 95.5 KLOS. Bye.
Oh. Hey, Dad, we're in the guard shack now. This is security guard Roger. He wants to say happy birthday.
Hi, Dad. How are you? Listen, come out and see me sometime.
Yeah. Roger sees everyone when they come in. I guess these are some listeners picking up tickets, are you?
Absolutely.
All right.
Hi, Nicole, Dad.
They're picking up tickets they've won from us. I hope it's a good show.
Thanks.
All right, Roger, say goodbye.
Bye, Dad. Take care.
Bye, Nicole, Dad.
This is Lisa. She does traffic. She schedules all the commercials and the logs and brings me logs when I don't sign off of them or forget to check off that a commercial ran.
And that's her favorite part of the job. Alan, I hope you enjoy this video. Have a great time with it. And I thought this was a great idea. I think I'm going to do it for my dad. But
happy birthday.
Happy birthday. That's right. Happy birthday and happy Thanksgiving and Merry Christmas and Happy New Year all at once.
Dad, this is Rosemary, who works in the programming department.
Hi, Alan. Bon anniversaire, as I say in French. I am taking French classes. Italian, I have no idea how they say it, but molto bene is probably good enough, right? Happy birthday. Nicole's a great daughter.
I paid
she
everyone to say
about
that.
You all the time. She lets us know how you're doing, and we hope you get better. Have a good one, and give her a big kiss, because she's happy to be there with you. Aww. See ya.
And going through the door, there's Rita again.
Hi,
you met her on Saturday.
How you doing? We're here working at the computer.
computer, see, picking all the hits for KLOS.
The music director, so she programs all our music.
And it's all very much fun, all the different songs and different categories and stuff like that. So we're having fun, and we hope that you're having a wonderful birthday. And we just think that this is a tremendous idea that you get to see where Nicole works and all that fun stuff and all the crazy people that she hangs out with.
Yeah, I spend way too many hours a day here. And see, Rita's the music director, and her office is clean too.
Not
see, Dad?
Even. Look over here.
Wait.
Look over there.
Yeah,
look
but
over there.
But compared to my office.
Well, compared to your office, Nicole.
But it's not my fault. It's not all my fault.
Yeah, she has to take care of those two babies all the time.
Yeah.
Hey.
What is that? And there's Gino. Gino, say hi and happy birthday to my dad.
Hi, Dad. How you doing?
Gino's on the air from 2 to 6. He's a kind of wild and crazy kind of guy.
Yeah, but I got cool socks.
Let me see. Wow. Let's go in. All right, we're going to go in close on
very musical socks.
All right, we're zooming in on them.
They smell good, too.
Wow. Were those a gift, or did you, like, pay for them?
Yes.
And Gino discovered Tim Allen.
We discovered each other. Hi, Rita.
Okay, Dad, this is Karen. She's Bill Summers' secretary, and it was actually her idea to do this video.
Hey, happy birthday, Alan.
And there's Bill again. See how he looks on a Wednesday? Different than on a Saturday, right? He's wearing a tie.
This is what I have.
Four copies today.
Four copies right away. I hope you have a great birthday, Alan.
No, okay, Dad, that's Carrie.
That's Carrie.
That's Arlo. Carrie's the program director. I think you met him.
He's the one, gay, I'm straight.
He's the one who
the
quit.
We both
he left us and then he came back. There's Brian.
And this is the general manager of the station.
Yes, yes.
Would you quit doing the sexual stuff? This is my dad.
Oh, sorry, but he's not gay. I'm gay, but
where
not.
Did they get a model of my penis? That's what I want to know.
See what I have to put up with every day?
Happy birthday to you.
Singing it.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Alan. Happy birthday to you!
Yeah, they're real into this, aren't
good
they?
To talk to you. Good to talk to you.
Say bye.
Bye.
Hi, Dad. It's now about 4:30. I just got home from work, believe it or not. And, well, I actually cheated a little bit. I went upstairs first to make sure the apartment was clean, and yes, it is, because the maid came while I was gone. That's my garage. That's my garage. There's the ocean. In the distance, it's not so far in the distance. I'm not going to walk across the street now because the sun's going to go down soon. But that's the end of the block. Pacific Coast Highway. Oh, my great camera work again. Pacific Coast Highway over there. And I'll walk you inside my building. Let me go wide again. I can you tell I really haven't gotten the swing of this yet? This is my building. Kind of weird looking, huh? But I do have this two-car garage. That's my bedroom window up there. That's my balcony. And these people just moved out, so maybe I'll get some good new neighbors. Want to see what the empty apartment looks like? You can't really see. You can see my reflection. Whoops, there's somebody in there. All right. Now we're walking into the building. Looks like while I was gone, they did some work on the pool. Looks like they're draining it. There's Philippe. He's the guy who kind of takes care of the building. I'm making a video for my dad. Are we draining the pool? Oh, what happened to it? Oh. All right, they put a rope across it, and now they're putting water back in the pool. But that's the pool. And we're going to go upstairs now. Did we get new neighbors upstairs?
Yeah.
Who are they?
Jason.
Nice couple?
Yeah, she's
okay. Okay, I'll meet them sometime. Not see you later.
On video.
Nah. Nah. I'm showing my apartment. Yeah, a few people moved out recently, so I guess there are new neighbors right there on in the second door over there. And there's the pool downstairs. And this is my apartment. Actually, it's unlocked only because I was just up here and I dropped off my suitcases and stuff. Say, apartment 7, And the guy who lived here before was named Dylan von Koffer, so I left his name on the door. Okay, and as we walk in, there's a Bruce Springsteen thing. There are still boxes, yes. I've lived in this apartment for, probably 7 months now, and I still have boxes all over the place. I'll show you everything, okay? Here's my roll-top desk. Wait, am I on wide angle now? Yeah, I guess. Roll-top desk, pictures and stuff, and a little thing here. That goes out to my balcony, I think. I already had you out there, but I didn't let you see the inside. You remember that, right? There's a TV and stereo. There's a... It's hard to get a good perspective on the room, I guess. My furniture you haven't seen yet. There's my big chair in the middle of the room. There's my couch. I have to show you some of the pictures. That, I should have kept it closed, is my German Dances with Wolves partner poster. Told you I'm tired. German Dances with Wolves poster that Kevin Costner signed to me. Brian got this for me last year for Christmas. See what it says? See you at the movies, signed Kevin Costner. Okay. There are all my CDs. There's a few of them there, and books and stuff. Show you. Picture of me with James Taylor. Picture of me with Chevy Chase, that's signed. There's my suitcase. Okay, now we'll walk into the kitchen. Dun, dun, dun. Some of my flowers have died while I was gone. But this is the kitchen. My nice table and chairs. My little stove. Little refrigerator. Little sink. And no, I don't have a dishwasher. Okay, so that's the kitchen. Nice big kitchen. Coffee pot that Minda gave me a couple years ago. I still use it every morning. Okay. Now we'll walk. Oh. And that's an actual cell from Chuck Jones, director of all these cartoons. Oh. And that's our picture with Bruce Springsteen. You saw it sitting on Lori's desk. There's my copy of it. And more boxes. Okay. Closets. The bathroom. The bathroom. Not really much of interest in here. It's kind of a small bathroom. And the bedroom. Got lots of closets. Two things of closets, window there. Another Bruce Springsteen poster. Another box. And you remember that, don't you? See, it's hanging in right over the dresser in the bedroom. So that's the apartment. And I really love it here. It's a great place. The neighbors are nice. That guy, Philippe, he's actually great. And if ever I have a problem, all I have to do is go downstairs and call him. And he comes right up and fixes it. Here's my plaque from the city of Los Angeles. See? I don't remember what it was for. Oh, it was for the Don't Drink and Drive show. We do a drunk show every St. Patrick's Day, where the guys get drunk on the air. I don't. They do. And here are some pictures from the show. I'm waiting for this to focus. Maybe a little too close. Let me back off a bit. Okay. That's us with James Taylor. That's me with Tom Selleck. That's me with Dana Delaney. That's us with Kenny Loggins. That's me with Ringo Starr. And that's us with Kelsey Grammer from Cheers. I don't know what else is interesting here. That's a thing from Aladdin we just got. That's a thing I got from Disneyland. See the Mickey Mouse? See what it says on the bottom? It says, my name, thanks for your phantasmic support. And there's a picture Marcy did, and there's another one in my bathroom. And that's pretty much it. It's kind of small. Oh, I got to show you my gold record. I got my first ever gold record.
Mark Cohn, who, Dad, you know what? I bet you'd like his music. It's really, really good. Maybe I'll send you a tape of it. Can you see what it says? I don't know if it'll focus this close. It says, presented to Nicole Sandler, KLOS, to commemorate the sale of more than 500,000 copies of the Atlantic Records cassette and CD Marcone. Pretty neat, huh? I think so. I've been wanting one of those for a long time. We finally got it. So that's pretty much it. I turned this around, but I don't think it'll focus on me.
Long day, it's been a long week. What I have to do now is take a nap. Oh, actually, I don't know if you can see it, I'm not in focus, but there's the thing that says my gift from Marcy is here. It's in the manager's office, I'm gonna go get it. And then I'm gonna lie down and take a nap, and then I'm gonna unpack, and then I'm gonna pack. And I'll see you tomorrow night. I'll probably shoot something in the studio tomorrow morning, but nothing more tonight, I'm too tired. See you later.